biology.
So very much welcome to this class, whereby in this class we are going to discuss on gaseous exchange in animals, whereby we'll see that different animals have different respiratory surface. Example, we see that the cell membrane is the respiratory surface for the amoeba. We have the gill filaments for the fish and the tadpoles. We have the tracheal system for the insects. And we also have the alveoli or the lungs for all the organisms in kingdom Chordata. We also have the skin for frogs and the earthworms. And then finally, we have the buccal cavity for the frogs. So we see that many gases exchange takes place in the respiratory surface through the process of diffusion. And what are the characteristics of the respiratory surface? So they must have a very large surface area to volume ratio. They must also be moist for easier diffusion of gases. And they must also have a large capillary network. And then finally, the gases exchange must also be very thin for easier diffusion of gases. So, first of all, let's look at gases exchange in the unicellular organism, whereby an example of the unicellular organism, we have the protozoa, we also have the bacteria, and we also have the amoeba. So mainly this organism use their cell membrane as their respiratory surface. So let's go to the next one, whereby we are going to look at gaseous exchange in insect. So the insect has a large network of air tubes, which are called the tracheal system. So the tracheal system penetrates to all the body parts to improve gaseous exchange efficiency. So it mainly consists of the spiracles. We have the trachea and the tracheoles. So the spiracles are the external opening on either side of the abdomen and the thorax of the insect, whereby air enters the body. So each spiracle has a muscular valve that mainly controls the opening and the closing. So on this valve, there are different hair-like projections preventing excess water loss from the body by evaporation. So these spiracles open into large air tubes called the trachea, which penetrate the whole body of the insect. So the tubes are reinforced with a cheating band, as this mainly keeps them open, preventing them from collapsing. Since when they collapse, therefore it will mean that no gaseous exchange process will take place. So the trachea then subdivides to tracheoles, facilitating the supply of materials into the body tissue. So let's now look on the mechanisms of gaseous exchange in the tracheal system. So how does gaseous exchange mainly take place in the tracheal system? So air is drawn into and out of the tracheal system by muscular movements of the abdominal walls. For example, in wasps and in bees, we see that the abdominal walls mainly move longitudinally, while for the cockroach and the locust, the walls mainly move laterally. So when the spiracle valves are open, air is drawn into the tracheal system. So after that, the valve will then close and air is forced along the system by the different muscles contained in it. So these different muscle movements will then close the valve. So oxygen, on the other hand, diffuses in due to the high diffusion gradient, as carbon dioxide will diffuse out into the tracheal system due to low diffusion gradient. So the thoracic spiracle valve will then close, as the abdominal spiracle valve will however open. So here, the gas is released through the spiracle opening and into the abdomen of the insect, or into the abdomen of the insect. So let's now look on the gases exchange for the insects living in water, either the insects submerged or living on the water surface. So the insect living in submerged water use the tracheal gills and are seen as mainly pirated plates on either side of the abdomen. Example, we have the dragonfly and the mayfly larvae, as you can see on the diagram. So most of these insects are not truly aquatic, since at one point or the other they must come out to breathe in the free flowing air from the atmosphere. So example is the mosquito larvae, which has spiracles near the rectum of the tube called the respiratory siphon, as you can see on the diagram. That is the diagram of the respiratory siphon. So this siphon is opened when the larvae comes to the surface of the water to take in air from the open surrounding. So it is then immediately closed by valve when this larvae is submerged in water. So it is then opened just beneath the head and pierced through the water for gaseous exchange. So some of the water insects, like the water beetle and the water bugs, mainly use air bubbles trapped by the hair on their bodies for gaseous exchange. So the air bubbles give this organism a silvery appearance when they come from the open air into the water surface. So however, we see that not all will come to the surface to get air. So others will use some respiratory devices which are called the plastron. So this is a very fine, non-washable hair that covers the cuticle. It also holds off water, maintaining a layer of air around the body. So let's now look on the adaptations of the tracheal system of the insect. So how are they adapted for gaseous exchange? So the first one, we'll see that the spiracles have a stiff hair to trap air particles. Also, we see that the spiracles have a mechanism for warming the air for easier diffusion of the air into the bodies of the insect. So we also see that the trachea have chitin or a ternidium structure which mainly keep them open and preventing them from collapsing. Also, we see that the trachea are hollow for easier gas passage. Not to forget the characteristics of the respiratory surface, which also apply here, whereby the respiratory surface must have numerous blood vessels, it must be thin, it must be moist, and it also must be well ventilated. So finally, let's look at the mechanisms of ventilation in insects. And we'll see that when the spiracle valve opens, oxygen enters the trachea system due to the low pressure created as a result of the relaxation of the abdominal muscles. So the spiracle valve here will eventually close. So what happens to oxygen? We see that oxygen will be forced into the tracheal system, whereby gases exchange takes place in the tracheole, which are in direct contact with the tissue of the body. So here, oxygen diffuses along the concentration gradient into the tissue fluid, where the concentration is very low. So carbon dioxide diffuses along the concentration gradient into the tracheole, where it is expelled through the spiracles into the air after the concentration of the abdominal muscle declines. So let's now meet on the next class as we now look on gaseous exchange in the bony fish. Biology.